We're all familiar with traditional 2D printing, printing out documents like letters or memos on paper. 3D printing is the process of making a solid, three-dimensional object out of a digital file. With recent advances in this technology, people can print everything from hearing aids to design products like furniture. The best part is that it requires less material than traditional manufacturing methods. Today, 3D printing is mostly either a fun, if expensive, hobby, or an important part of a company's industrial supply chain. But research firms predict that the field is going to grow into a multi-billion dollar industry in the next 5 years. Is this an opportunity for you to take advantage? I'm Eric Goldschein, editor at Fundera, and if you're interested in starting up a 3D printing business, this video will help you cover the bases and get your venture off the ground. Here are 5 steps to starting your own 3D printing business. Step 1 is cover the entrepreneurship basics. Whether your hobby or side hustle is 3D printing or anything else, if you want to make something into a business, you need to cover some of the basics. So we've got a comprehensive guide on the 10 steps you need to take when starting a business, which is linked in the description below. But I'll pull out some of the high-level stuff for you right now. You need to, number 1, write a business plan. This means doing market research, selecting a certain 3D printing niche, more on this in a second, understanding how much funding you need to get started, and planning for how you'll grow. Maybe you have to decide where you'll find customers and things like that. This is where you write the story of your business from the beginning to the end, as you see it today. The second thing is choose your business's legal structure. Are you going to be an LLC, an S-Corp, or sole proprietor? There are financial and legal benefits to each. The third thing is to register your business. This includes registering a business name, getting a tax ID number, and registering for state and local taxes. The fourth thing would be to obtain funding. Some of what you'll need to run a 3D printing business isn't cheap, like the printer. Do you have the cash on hand to pay for your startup investments? If not, where are you going to get your funds? Friends and family? Startup loan? It's time to start researching this. The fifth thing would be get some business financial tools. Look for a business credit card and a business bank account, so you can separate your business and personal finances, and the money that your business makes has a place to live. There's a lot more to this process, including potentially finding a storefront and hiring employees, but let's move on to the next steps, since they'll dictate the size, scope, and details of your 3D printing business. Step 2 is choose your niche. You can print all kinds of things with a 3D printer, but that doesn't mean you're going to print everything. Industries that use 3D printing include automotive, aviation, and aerospace industries. As a small business owner starting out in this arena, you're probably not going to 3D print on that scale, though that could be an option in the future as you grow. To start, pick a field where you see an opportunity to serve consumers or other businesses. That could mean designing and printing consumer products like eyewear and jewelry, or healthcare products like crowns and dentures. If you need some inspiration, the Fundera team put together a list of 3D printing business ideas, covering everything from custom-made tools and rare parts to sustainable fashion and collectibles. We'll link that in the description below as well. The niche of 3D printing that you choose will dictate everything, of course, but most pressingly, it will dictate the materials that you need, the printer you use, and other important startup investments. Moving on to step 3, which is select your software. As you probably know, a major part of 3D printing is building 3D models, and you can't do that with Microsoft Paint. You'll need 3D modeling software that is robust enough for business use. When getting started, you can find open source and otherwise free software with really simple tools and features to help you get a handle on how to design 3D models. Well-regarded, popular options include Tinkercad, Blender, and Design Spark Mechanical. Eventually, you will want to upgrade to a professional version of certain softwares or industrial-grade software, which can cost hundreds or even thousands of dollars a year in licensing fees. These fees will be worth it. The paid software options will have incredible capabilities and tools that will help you model, animate, and render professional-level products. You may also need slicing tools, which is software that takes a CAD model, slices it into layers, and then turns your model into G-code. Your 3D printer reads this G-code and prints the model layer by layer. Does all of this sound confusing to you? It may be worth it to invest in a training course on 3D modeling and animation so you can understand how to best use the tools available to you. You'll save yourself hours of trial and error in the long run. Look into a local course or research what's available online. Step 4 is invest in your hardware and materials. In order to 3D print, you'll need a 3D printer, as well as the materials necessary to create your products. You have two options here: turn to a third-party printer or invest in buying your own. In the former scenario, you become something of a 3D printing middleman. In the latter, you handle all the production yourself. If you want to buy your own printer, consider questions such as how many items you'll typically need to print, the scale of those options. Are they small, like eyeglass frames, or large, like entire homes? How detailed your creations are, and what material you'll use. Different printers will use different processes and require different materials. There are a handful of different methods you can use to print. They include, and here comes the hard part, okay? Vat photo polymerization, material jetting, binder jetting, material extrusion, and others. In order to decide the process for you, check out 3dprinting.com's rundown of each printing process. We'll link that in the description below too. No doubt the product that you're looking to print will dictate what process you'll use. Okay, step five is begin marketing your business and making connections. You got your printer, your software, your materials, and your ideas. The last part of starting a 3D printing business is the part where you do business. You need to find customers and clients to sell your products to. Right now, the market is fairly limited for straight up selling wares from your 3D printer. It will be difficult to compete on price with products manufactured and sold by larger firms. You may be able to carve out a niche selling specific items, such as customizable earbuds or artwork. To market these items, you'll need to set up an e-commerce site and use a mix of traditional and digital marketing, including email and social media, to get the word out about your business. If you're looking to create a B2B business, that's business to business, attending trade shows, using direct mailers, cold calling, are just a few of the ways that you can drum up business. 3D printing may also just be one part of a larger business you have, which you use to complete custom and unique orders. 3D printing is still coming into its own, so prepare to play the long game when it comes to finding profitable ways to use this emerging technology. That does it for our rundown on how to start a 3D printing business. For more information on starting any kind of business, visit fundera.com and the Ledger blog, and subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching.